bring forth our brother, Brother Barfor, who was with the Food Sovereignty and the Black Star Line, to give us a few words on what we need to do to secure our food and to make sure that we invest in our own banks.
Mm-hmm.
Greetings, brothers and sisters, and welcome home. Akwapa. My name is Kwikwando. I volunteer for a civil society organization called Food Sovereignty Ghana. And we exist for social justice. One of the flagship issues that we've been fighting for is for the against the imposition of genetically modified organisms into our food chain. Now, all of you coming from the U.S. will know that in the U.S. you have GMOs. In fact, the U.S. is the one that produced GMOs to the world. Ironically, there's no labeling laws in the U.S., but that whole move is finding its way across the water. There's a very strong lobby, very strong corporate lobby. A lot of our politicians have been compromised. A lot of our media people, our scientists have been compromised. So I think maybe 3 weeks, a month ago, we have scientists who came on the media saying that GMOs are even safer than conventional crops. That's how far the lobby is taking them, that these people are being, influenced to influence us, you know, to let go of the last connection that we have with our maker. You know, the foods that we find ourselves living around in these tropics were deliberately placed here by the Creator for the benefit of our bodies. And we're finding that increasingly, because of corporate greed and just sheer need to human manipulation, our food systems are being attacked. So there's this drive to push GMOs, and there's this false reasoning that the world population is growing and there's soon going to be less land, and we need to feed increasing populations. But the truth is, you're just about to go drive through Ghana. As you're driving through Ghana, you're going to see that along the road, for as far as you'll drive around, there's food, an abundance of food. There's food that you don't even know is food. And so it is absolutely illegal for people to be pushing down African countries that exist in the tropics to say that we must genetically modify our biodiversity. We have plants and grains and seeds and animals that we don't even know the benefit to us yet. And this is the reason why we must protect our biodiversity. Yes. We feel that our biodiversity is the wealth of the future. You know, and so these are very heavy machinations that are being pushed through. Like I said again, you won't hear much positive stuff about it in the media because the media has been compromised. A lot of people are being paid for it, a lot of the media houses. But you play an important role in coming home. If you have an interest in organic farming, if you have an interest in agriculture, I want to urge you to go into the organic side of farming, because the world is showing that there's an increase in demand for organic food. So you know that out there in the US, you pay more for organic food than you pay for normal conventional food. So that means that there's a growing market across the world. And if you're in Ghana and you're able to export organic food, organic pawpaws, organic mangoes, pineapples, whatever it is, there's a growing market around the world. We can't even get enough organic food. So for those of you interested in agriculture, I'd urge you, when you go back, look for links. You know, we have different types of rich foods here, baobab powder, shea nut butter, you know, coconut oil, different health foods that our families need that you could easily be an agent for, or find a market out there, or get into a farm here. We have a website, www.foodsovereigntyghana.org. So I urge you all to visit it and to support us. We're a very small civil society organization. So, all the bulk of the funds is on the other side of the argument, because they can't wait for the day when we'll all be begging before we eat. But we need to open our eyes seriously, because the independent research all over the world shows that genetically modified organisms, when consumed, are injurious to the body. Liver toxicity, kidney problems, infertility problems, immune system problems. And we're starting to see it in Ghana. Ghanaians who live here can tell you that we see obituaries, gone too soon, oh, what a shock. People die now at 22, 36, 44. which never used to happen when we were younger. So there is something happening in the system, and that's because we import a lot of food from the US, a lot of food that comes through the borders. So the fact that we haven't started physically growing them here doesn't mean that GMOs aren't in the system. And we're starting to see the degradation of our health. So it's very important that we support, you know, organic agriculture, and just not to believe the hype. So when you speak to your brothers and sisters here, let them know that, you know, what the scientists are telling us here is false. It's just to push a corporate agenda. We grow enough food. Food rots on our farms. We rather need roads, we need warehouses, we need credit to farmers. But the last thing we need in Ghana is to genetically modify our crops. You know, and so we want you to visit Food Sovereignty Ghana and support our work. I'm also the vice chair of the Black Starlight Credit Union, and our chairperson, Naomi, is here. So Naomi is a repatriate. She's been here for 14 years, and I'll let her say something about the Black Starlight Credit Union.
Oh, but